Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the International Handel Festival Göttingen 2014. It's actually the oldest festival for baroque music worldwide, but also a very much forward-looking festival, and I'm very proud that I can present to you today the artistic director of the festival, Lawrence Cummings.
Hello, and it's a great pleasure for me to be here. It's the most fantastic festival to be involved with. This is my third year now as artistic director, and I love the atmosphere that the town creates for our festival, and of course our very loyal public who allow us to put on this wonderful series of concerts and opera allow us to invite all our wonderful international guests.
This year we're doing the opera Faramondo. It hasn't been done in Göttingen at all. What's it all about?
Well, Faramondo is a really first-rate opera, in my opinion. It's full of the most fantastic music. The orchestration is fantastic, the vocal lines are absolutely wonderful, and as ever, Handel captures the emotions of the characters as telling the story. I think perhaps one of the reasons it hasn't been done for so long is because of the dramaturgy, but actually, as in any story, if you tell the story well, the music is absolutely married to the drama, and so will make a fantastic evening in the theatre.
And who keeps this all together? Who's the director?
We have a wonderful director, Paul Curran, who I think it's safe to say in rehearsals there's never a dull moment. He's got a very wonderful sense of humour, but also a really fantastic sense of storytelling. He wants the story to be as immediate as possible for the audience, so that they really understand every moment, but also that it serves the music, so that all the characters are able to have their crises or their moments of joy and allow the music to be married to whatever's going on stage.
And we have had historical performances on stage, historical productions. Is this going to be a historical Baroque production, a Baroque view on the piece?
Very much a modern production. And it's an interesting question because, of course, Göttingen is famous for its historical performance and its Baroque productions over the years. And my predecessor, Nick McGeegan, was a wonderful exponent of that. For me, I think it's interesting to have a variety of productions. And so this year, it is a modern production. It's set in a casino. The characters are wearing modern clothes, glamorous modern clothes, but nonetheless modern. And we're telling the story as if the casino represents the palace. So it's a little bit akin to something like The Sopranos on television.
We have talked about the opera Faramondo, and one very important play in that opera is, of course, the Festival Orchestra. What's so special about the Festival Orchestra?
The Festival Orchestra is certainly one of the best orchestras in the world. It was founded by Nicholas McGeegan in 2006, and he just assembled the most amazing musicians together. It was a wonderfully interesting conceit because he wanted to use his friends and colleagues, and he appointed the principals, for instance, the string sectional principals, and then ordered them to go off shopping for their favourite players. And the result is just this wonderful, wonderful mix of playing styles and characters who come from all sorts of different backgrounds, and we all come together, and after about half an hour of playing together in the first rehearsal, suddenly this incredible sound comes about. And it's so wonderful to have so many different influences. There are people from the States, there are people from Czechoslovakia, Slovakia, Germany, England, Italy. It's just a wonderful melting pot.
And they're not only playing the opera, they're also playing the oratorio. Which is the oratorio this year?
This year we're doing Joshua, fantastic oratorio. It's a military oratorio, the idea being to buoy up society and make the monarch George II even more popular than he was already. It's got battles, they have the walls of Jericho falling down, we have trumpets, drums, horns. It's a very dramatic piece, and full of life, and as Handel does so well, he leaves you after the performance feeling better.
We've got not only got the oratorio but also the coronation anthems, and in both pieces you've got the NDR choir. It's the third year you're working with them, so what's so special about this choir?
They sing so magnificently, they're so stylish. We hardly have to talk about any details because they know what to do already, and they make such a wonderful sound.
And are you doing any chamber concerts this year?
Yes, doing two chamber concerts, one with my London-based chamber group, the London Handel Players. We're doing a lovely mixed programme. And then also with my dear colleague Hanneke, we're doing a two harpsichord recital, although not just a two harpsichord recital, because Hanneke also plays the recorder, and so she's playing the recorder, and I'm also going to sing. And she's also written a piece specially for our concert, so we're very excited about it.
And apart from these chamber concerts, we've got a lot more to offer, for example, in the region, for example, also in the part of education. And you've already seen one production we've done in our Handel for Kids programme.
Yes, the hip-hop opera was fantastic. They'd written their own words for the rap numbers, and it was just so full of life. The orchestra was fantastic and so beautifully prepared, and the whole thing, I thought, was a huge success.
Talking about the motto of the festival, it's Handel Royal, Herrschaftszeiten in German. What does it relate to?
Well, this is a very exciting year because, of course, it's the anniversary of the Hanoverian succession to the throne in England. Of course, it's particularly nice for me because a lot of the connections are to do with my hometown, London, and I'm enjoying learning a lot, actually, about Georgian society and also the musical things that were happening and the different music associated with monarchs of the period.
And is there anything you want to give away concerning the festival up to 2020, perhaps, already?
Well, we are planning quite a long way in advance. We have a mission to have performed all of the Handel operas by the anniversary year, 2020, and we're on track for doing that. That's not to say that we won't be also putting some firm favourites in the mix as well. And we are going to have a variety of productions. There will be some historical productions in there and also some modern ones.
Thank you very much for visiting us online here. We'd be very happy to welcome you in Göttingen for the International Handel Festival 2014. I'm Tobias Wolf, and
I'm Lawrence Cummings, Artistic Director. Please do come.